This video tutorial I will explain what is HTTPS protocol and how does HTTPS work and why most of the website needed HTTPS protocol. Left side you can see HDFC Bank website, right side you can see HDFC Bank server. Suppose the HDFC Bank website is using HTTP protocol, then whatever information sent from this browser to this HDFC Bank will be plain text. Suppose the user enters credit card number and password and send it from this browser to this HDFC Bank server will be the plain text. And that can be easily intercepted and read by the hackers. And hackers will read and they can misuse the data. So without HTTPS, the communication between the browser and the server is a plain text. And this means whatever password we are entering or credit card number we are entering and send it over this internet can be easily read by anyone who has the ability to intercept it. And they will read this data and they can misuse it. Instead of HTTP protocol, if you are using HTTPS protocol, then whatever data sent from this HDFC Bank website to this HDFC Bank server is encrypted. And this connection is encrypted connection. Suppose a hacker intercepts this data, what hacker will see is jumbled data. From that, hacker cannot make out what is the actual data sent from this HDFC Bank website to this HDFC Bank server. If we are using HTTPS protocol, then data sent over the internet is unreadable by anyone other than sender and the receiver. HTTPS protocol is an extension of HTTP protocol. By using HTTPS protocol, the data is sent over the internet is in encrypted form using something called TLS. TLS stands for Transport Layer Security. If the encrypted data gets intercepted by hacker, all the hacker could see is the jumbled data. And this is where TLS handshake comes in the picture. We will see how this handshake works next. There are several steps involved in handshake. The step one is the browser establishes TCP connection with the server. The client sends TCP sync request to the server and server sends back TCP sync plus acknowledgement back to the client. Then the client sends TCP acknowledgement back to the server. Then the TCP connection will be established. In step 2, TLS handshake begins. The browser sends client hello message to the server. And in this hello message, the browser tells two things to the server. The first one is what TLS version the browser can support. It could be TLS 1.2, TLS 1.3 and so on. And what cipher suits the browser can support. And cipher suit is nothing but set of encryption algorithms which is used to encrypt the data. After receiving a client hello message from client, the server has to choose what TLS version and what cipher suit the server has to use based on the option it got from the client. And then it sends a server hello message back to the client. The server hello message contains what TLS version and what cipher suit the server is going to use. After sending a server hello message, the server sends a certificate to the client. And this certificate includes lot of different things. One of the key thing is the public key for the server. And the client uses the public key in asymmetric encryption. In asymmetric encryption, the piece of data which is encrypted by public key can be only be decrypted by the private key. And after sending a certificate and public key to the client, the server sends a server hello done message to the client. And this concludes the step 2, which is hello phase of the TLS handshake. And at this point, the client has a server certificate, and the client and server have agreed on TLS version and the cipher suit. In step 3, the client and server comes up with shared encryption key, and this shared encryption key is used to encrypt the data, and this is where asymmetric encryption comes into picture. With asymmetric encryption, the data is encrypted on the client side using the public key which a client got from the server, and the encrypted data can only be decrypted by the server using the private key. And this is how the client sends encryption key safely to the server over the internet, and all this is done in the client key exchange message. The exact details varies depending on the cipher suit used. Suppose if we use RSA cipher suit for an example, then using RSA cipher suit, the encryption key will be generated. The encryption key is nothing but the session key, and this session key will be encrypted using asymmetric encryption algorithm using the public key which client got from the server. Then encrypted session key will be created, and client send this encrypted session key to the server over the internet, and the server receives the encrypted session key, and using a private key the server can decrypt the session key. Now both client and server has session key. Now the step 4 is data transmission. In this step, both the client and the server has session key, and using this session key and agreed upon cipher suit, the client will encrypt the data and send it to the server. Same way, using this session key and agreed upon cipher suit, the server will encrypt the data and send it to the client. And this time it will use symmetric encryption, not asymmetric encryption, because asymmetric encryption is computationally expensive, and asymmetric encryption is not something suitable for bulk data transmission. For bulk data transmission, we have to use symmetric encryption. The handshake which we talked about is applied to TLS 1.2, and the latest version is TLS 1.3, and TLS 1.3 is supported in all major browsers. And as we have seen, TLS 1.2 takes 2 network round trips to complete, but TLS 1.3 optimizes the handshake to reduce number of network round trip to 1. But the core concept in TLS 1.2 still applied to TLS 1.3. In the above explanation, we have used RSA for asymmetric encryption to securely exchange the symmetric session key. Again, we choose RSA because it is easy to understand. However, asymmetric encryption is not the only way to share the session key between the client and the server. In fact, in TLS 1.3, RSA is no longer supported as a method for key exchange. Diffie-Hellman is more common way nowadays for exchanging session keys. Diffie-Hellman is complicated, but in nutshell, it uses some advanced math which involves large prime numbers to derive a shared session key without ever transmitting public key over the network.
you can get the Java source code link from the description section of the video. To see the description in mobile, click on this icon and it will expand like this. Then click on this more button to see the description. And in the description, you can see the links. And click on these links to get the Java source code.